premium weed. Dopecast 420, the Pacific Northwest.
All right, this is a special moment here at Oregon's Finest. It's a Dopecast 420, and our first guest, Mike Fox. Michael Fox.
That's it.
State director, Dope Magazine, ready for worldwide domination.
That's what we're doing. That's the mission.
All right. So as you can see, everybody, here we go. It's going to start. The timer,
four minutes
and 20 seconds. That's all the time we get. When the buzzer goes, the show is over.
That's it.
That's the way it goes.
That's all she wrote.
Tell us a little bit about May's issue. Cliff Robinson, Uncle Spliffy.
Well, I have no issues with May, but May issue is Cliff Robinson, man. Uncle Spliffy is one of my favorite guys. I mean, as far as a person that's passionate about cannabis, a person that's passionate about his lifestyle in and out of cannabis, his kids, his career. I mean, he's a good dude. I mean, and have him on the cover.
He's the whole package.
He is. He really is.
He's a hero to Stumptown. I mean, everybody loves him.
Chronic game changer. That's the Cliff Robinson we're talking about.
That's it.
If you're not familiar, pick up the issue.
Oh yeah, you can pick up Dope Magazine at Oregon's Finest too. By the way, there you go.
Yeah.
A little bit of plug for both of us there.
You know, you guys have been on the reel with this. We've been blessed to work with Oregon's Finest as an advertiser, as friends. Mark said I go way back.
I mean,
he's a great guy. I mean, everybody you guys have, Troy, what you guys do just it's commendable. I mean, you're out there with great brands, and you're doing great branding, and it doesn't matter if you guys did cannabis or shoes. I really do. You guys get it.
Man, we'd sell some sweet kicks.
Woo!
I got to tell you. But, I'm blessed to be a part of the whole team.
Yeah.
I really am, and they embrace the ideas that everybody has and everything that goes along with it, which is fantastic. And just kind of like your folks at Dope Magazine. You guys come in a lot. We say hi. We're not too far. We're kind of neighbors.
You say we say hi or stay high?
Both.
Yeah. That is.
Yeah, it's got to be both.
You are literally our neighborhood dispensary.
That's cool.
I mean, that's a blessing in and of itself. We come down from the 16th floor and get to say hi to you guys.
And the other cool thing is we're going to have lots of guests on the show. And the producer's pointing. I'm a radio guy.
Yeah.
Can I just say that, everybody? I'm a radio guy. 25 years. I've done like 2 minutes of TV.
it's sad because you got the face for television.
No, I'm heinous. It's
no,
terrible.
It's face for television.
It's funny. I got the beard going now too. But we're going to be here every week. We're going to come in. We're going to talk to folks like yourself. We're going to talk to senators. We're going to talk to shop owners. We're going to talk to vendors. We're going to talk to growers. We're going to talk to activists.
You're going to defend our plant everywhere. You're going to keep
it dope. That's what you do.
Yeah. That's what you do, too. I mean,
that's what we should all be doing.
Our community, I think that's, without sounding cheese ball, I mean, that's really what Dope Magazine, our hope is that we're bringing in people more than just from the cannabis industry, that we're bringing it from the everywhere, walks of life. Cannabis industry is your doctors, your lawyers, your guy next door, your gal next door.
Right.
It doesn't hold any prejudice. It doesn't hold any. The truth of cannabis is that everybody's welcome if you understand it and you're educated to it. It doesn't mean you have to smoke it or ingest it. You have to educate yourself on it. And that's what really I think our mission is, that defending our plant everywhere and getting out there and being activists means that, hey, we're not asking you to come over to this side and smoke and eat the newest edible and all that. But we're asking you to understand what it is and be understanding that this is not a drug.
Yeah. Yeah, you know, it's going to be it's an uphill battle for some of that older generation. But you know what I found that a lot of those some of those baby boomers who are regular customers, you know, are a little more hip, a little bit, they know what's going on. They, you know, I'm not a big drinker.
Yeah,
so it's one of those things, but I see it all the time. The older generation's embracing finally.
Well, I think legalization. Yeah.
Yeah, it's about time.
I got love for what you're doing, buddy.
All right. Well, we're going to be on YouTube. We're going to be on Periscope. We're going to be all over the place. That's just what we're going to do. And anything we can do to hang out with the guys at Dope Magazine, I'm down.
24
I hear you
states.
Guys throw pretty good parties.
Oh, you know we do. You guys check us out. 24 states, 3 countries later.
Yeah,
we're
tell
growing
me. You got, you got 30 seconds. Tell me a little bit about what's
30
happening.
Seconds, man. That's a big overview. 5 years in the making. Great people that brought this together. It is a core of amazing people. But really what we come down
David
to
Tran.
In a 30-second elevator. Yeah, David Tran, the father Tran. I mean, it's about everybody. It's the dispensaries. It's the it's the lawmakers. So we've had love from all over the world. And we want to bring that together and ask you guys to be part of that dope army. Go check us out, www.dopemagazine.com. See for yourself. What we're doing is an overall view of what the industry is. Much love.
That's it, brother.
Peace.
Thanks. Thank Michael Fox, State Director, Dope Magazine for Oregon. 4 minutes and 20 seconds. It's Dopecast 420, powered by Oregon's Finest. Have a good one.
Keep it dope.
Beaming to you from the Pacific Northwest, Dopecast420.com.
I may be one of the dumbest people in here, but I was smart enough to come up with that.